countries, we like to suffer. If there is no suffering, there is something wrong.
Curl it up.
Oh, it's nice.
I don't think anywhere else has this. After a while. So.
We're pretty poor.
Zdravstvuyte.
This is the second video of a two-part series about Kyiv.
I would say that air quality here kills way more people than COVID ever will. It's not cool that the city officials, the mayor, the government here cannot figure out some emission controls, because what I didn't notice until about after year one, and then I started getting headaches. The mayor can't be unaware of that if he travels into Europe, into Germany. The president's well-traveled. She's like, come on guys, fix that shit. It's not cool to put that on your population. And there are many days here you just don't want to go out into it. And a lot of people from here don't even notice. I mean, you don't notice unless you have something else really to compare it to.
Most of what?
Most of the people that have this huge wealth, that have a lot of money in Ukraine, they usually come from very poor childhood, and they basically overcompensated.
Oh, okay.
So that's why.
Okay. Guys, here we are. Yvonne in the mix. Yvonne from Lviv.
Yeah, yeah. It's like awkward.
Well, if anyone's watching all the videos, you might recognize him.
Yeah.
But for those that don't, Yvonne is going to tell us about the Golodomyr.
Holodomor.
Yvonne's going to tell us about the Holodomor.
Yes, that's good. That's
Holodomor, like good. Which the basic understanding I have is it was an event that happened 1932 to 1933, famine in Ukraine.
Yeah.
3 to 12 million people,
yes, around that,
died.
Yeah.
But why?
Because basically the communist government didn't want this, as they call them, kulaks, this wealthy village people. They didn't want them to become independent. And they were actually on their way to become independent because they were able to provide for themselves. They were raising crops and having small farms and ranches. So it was like the campaign was basically in order to destroy these small households.
Okay.
You know, to basically take everything away from them.
So these people were forming their own businesses, making money.
Yeah, yeah, they were
completely self-sufficient.
Yes, yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
So were the central authority out of Ukraine or out of Moscow? Do you know?
Of course, the main orders were coming out of Moscow, but generally there were people from Ukraine that were following those orders, and they were coming to these people and taking their food, everything they had, basically. Mm-hmm.
This is the World War II Memorial, right?
Yeah.
This? Okay, and then Holodomor is one over there. Okay, yeah. Let's go over there.
And basically, the idea also was to create this, like, to break them mentally and psychologically also, because they were suffering from starvation, obviously, but as well, when you live in this kind of situation and you see other people dying and eating each other, it's like, it's crazy. So the idea was also to break them down, to break their spirit completely.
Right. And so when I when people ask me from the US or from other countries, what's it like with the pandemic in Ukraine right now with Corona? And I'm like, I don't really feel like anyone's too worried, because you guys have had the Holodomor, you've had Stalin, you've had revolutions, banking crises, all these things that have happened in actual recent memory, where something like this pandemic is like a mosquito bite.
Yeah,
that's what
it
feels like.
Especially after Maidan in 2013. Well, to be honest with you, we became kind of tough as a boot after a while. I mean,
well, you guys did what Belarus is trying to do right now.
But they have different situation.
Oh, let's go through here.
Check this out.
Yeah, they have a tough mountain to climb for sure.
We like to suffer. So do you want to repeat this?
Oh, you can say it, man. Go for it.
I mean, yeah, if you might have noticed that we like to suffer. It's like, it's depicted basically in everything. It's like, if there is no suffering, there's something wrong.
So, no pain, no gain.
Yeah, that's exactly. That's
all right.
Exactly.
So here's the start of the memorial. And I was asking Yvonne why the the texture here is so rough. And that was the answer. You like to shelter.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
No comfort walking to the memorial. Makes sense, though. It's not a comfortable event.
Yeah, it's like reminds you of the, at least a little bit, like you having this little moment of discomfort, it reminds you of the rough past that we had to go through.
So I was saying, and this is just from my outside perspective,
yeah.
You obviously have a closer ear to the ground than I do, but Ukraine right now, the young people are like shooting towards newness in the sense they're experimenting, they're trying different things. You see a white guy making Indian food,
yeah.
You see all these new restaurants, new concepts, and my theory is because nobody wants to go back to Soviet times, the youth now,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And you only look in this way, whereas many European countries, like I was just in Italy, it's like you don't see the changes there that you see here, which is super interesting. It's a much wealthier country, but they're like, they have their pasta they've done forever and that's not going to change, right?
Yeah.
Which is cool. That's what I like about Italy. Like it's such a great experience to go there, but I don't feel like there's as much newness as here, which is really interesting.
Yeah, exactly, because we're very new to this taste of freedom, you know, and we
yeah.
It's like very fresh for us, so it's like very new experience, so that's why we're trying to taste it, we're trying to experiment, and we're enjoying ourselves right now.
You're enjoying yourself?
Yes, we are, as you can see right now, especially during this pandemic.
Yeah I mean, okay, let's this is, do you know what this symbolizes?
Can we we can't go past here. I'm a millennial. I'm allowed to not know.
Yeah, there it is. That's really interesting. Yes.
Хорошо.
So, in your youth, in your schooling, yeah. Was this history really drilled into you?
That's the funny thing, actually, because during that time, we had different presidents.
Uh-huh.
And one of those presidents, as you remember, was Yanukovych, and
yeah.
He was, like, pro-Russian. So
yeah.
He didn't want this history to be remembered,
oh.
Let's say, and his government didn't want to.
So when you were growing up, you weren't taught about
it? Yeah, no, I knew. I knew about it because my grandmother told me a lot about it when I was a little kid, like, a lot.
Uh-huh.
I spent all those notorious long winters in the village with her, and she
okay.
told me a lot about the hunger in 1932-33,
mm-hmm.
and also after the World War II in 1947, because
I mean,
she experienced this very...
Those are bigger deaths than the Holocaust, I think.
Yeah.
I don't know the exact numbers, so I gotta look at that, but I think that's like up there, right?
Yeah.
Stay in Ukraine, man. If I want to avoid any turmoil,
yes,
what
yes,
kind
like
of turmoil?
Any. Like for this, at this point in time in history, like this is the safest place, I think. At least it seems to me.
You think it's the safest
place?
Hydro Park.
Yeah.
This is an island on the Dnipro River.
Yeah.
And I've been here only once before. It's got like a funfair feel, right?
Yeah. But
what's your history with this place?
Was this place like it? History of the smell of piss and vomit. That's my history. That's
but there are beaches here. We're going to check out the beach.
Yeah.
Ivan, did you ever partake in this beach scene?
Yeah, when I used to be a little stupid and I didn't even. Didn't care much about hygiene and stuff. I used to, yeah.
What, you don't trust the water?
Cool.
It looks cool,
sure.
But that water I would not be jumping in because one of the tributaries comes from Chernobyl, right? Chernobyl River?
Yes, awesome. But
not
it's
far
like,
away.
Even take out the Chernobyl, it's like still dirty. It's like nobody gives a shit about cleaning this water.
Right. City officials or the government just has no interest in ecology. Like
exactly.
Zero.
Like it's like
air quality.
Like nature will clean itself. Like
yeah. I mean, it looks so cool though. Imagine if that was
But you
clean
know,
water.
You know, the funny part is like we already have the immune system to tolerate this kind of dirty water.
It's in your DNA. All right, there's this gym down here, a very famous, famous outdoor gym.
Yeah.
I'm not a gym guy at all, but it's worth it. We're checking it out. I actually came here a few weeks ago to check it out. Quite entertaining.
I have never been there, but it seems to me like the U.S. is like a huge echo chamber.
Yeah.
It's like it needs fresh air.
It's well said.
Yeah.
It does need fresh air with that stuff.
It seems to me like,
and we're talking about cancel culture and how people can get cut out immediately for saying the wrong thing. Okay, here we are. This is where people get ripped.
It's
in
like,
Kyiv, it's a free gym, right?
Man, it's like it's certain lighting and it's certain weather. It seems like a scene from the horror movie.
It's great though. This is awesome. Do a little swim, come out, and curl it up. This is cool though. I don't think anywhere else has this.
Yeah, yeah.
Look, it's just everything's like just tractor parts.
Shekels, and yeah.
Different welds. Homemade. Looks like they could. This gym could withstand a Chernobyl
two more.
Nuclear winter.
It'll be fine. Seriously, when it's overcast and when there's foggy weather, man.
Does the bar bend because the weight is so much? Is that right? That can't be right.
Well, I don't know.
No, this is thick steel. Yeah, it's just made that way.
Like very well preserved in terms of like Soviet culture. It's basically the way it was like 20 or 30 years ago. It's very USSR to use this kind of cover for this. Like when something gets bad,
the
like
pleather.
When the surface gets bad, we usually add this.
Oh,
shit.
It's like some
like
tablecloth stuff.
Very USSR. You'll never gonna find this anywhere else in the world.
So what do you miss about the USSR?
Nothing. I haven't been there. I don't want to go there.
Zero.
No, I don't.
This is cool. This is cool. This is unique.
It's like nice.
It's
like
not
a museum. It's like a museum. It's nice to visit, but no way in the world I would love to get back there. And
in the subconscious or the conscious?
Yeah, I think I'm 28 and I still have this remnants of this old bad habits that I know is like very USSR in terms of some kind of inner blocks and maybe mental blocks and all this like very what's allowed and what's not allowed, what's appropriate, what's not appropriate. It's like there is still like very deep the fuck down. It's ingrained. Our like the generation of my brother who's 18 right now, they fortunately they don't have it.
What's in these places?
It's like for garages, like for cars, and it's like this is something. It's also the very significant part of.
Здравствуйте. Make massage. Он вам надо быть.
Массаж?
Да.
Сколько времени?
50 минут 100 гривна.
Только ше.
Ше я 10 минут 50, но у меня там человек, вам придется подождать. Man after man.
Okay, я вернусь. Спасибо.
There's these are garage and this is like also very specific like USSR culture because men tend to have garage but not necessarily every of them have a car and they just love this place to hang out with
man
their
cave.
Buddies, drink beer, talk about women, have this like locker room talk. Like it's very also like very in like part of significant part of our culture of previous generations.
Right. All right guys, we're gonna go out to a beach here. Gonna show you a beach and wrap it up at a very cool new location here in Kyiv. Quite impressive, I gotta say. In the city limits, we have an island here. I think this is Truhaniv Island. A lot of paths, a lot of cool places to hang out there. Volleyball. Why don't you hang out over here? It's pretty cool.
I'm pretty sure you're a dancer.
I gotta say, you guys are pretty good at hanging out together, having a good time, not overstressing. Am I right on that? Not overstressing?
You know, it's like funny, it's like a paradox. We are able to overstress while hanging out, but we also manage to enjoy being stressed about some kind of shit, some kind of minutia. So it's like a part of our recreation process, I would say.
And what's this in here, like a beach club?
I don't know.
It's... I wanna see.
Just trying to see what is it.
I can't even see what the camera's saying.
And we are starting to wake up to the fact that we have to take care of our environment at least on some level.
Right.
At least on some level. And I'm pretty much optimistic about.
Because like there was no awareness in Soviet times, right?
Yeah. We want to elect the weird, the sportsman, the comedian guy, and just to see what happened, what's gonna happen. We just were curious.
Well, I think universally people are so sick of politicians.
Yeah, like even
it a
if
try.
It might, like even if there is a possibility for everything to go to hell in a handbasket, we're like, let's fucking check this.
Look at that Ferrari chilling out there.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Oh, here you have like a pretty stereotypical picture.
Explain it for me. What's the stereotypical picture?
That's what I was talking about in the beginning about the overcompensating. People who were pretty poor.
Здравствуйте.
What?
Open. Открыто. You want me to translate for you, bro?
I'm starting to forget my...
Ровшак. Открыто. This is what I mean about the city of contrast. We have that gym just in there in the trees, then the Ferrari and the beach club. Very, very much mixed up, brother. That's what I love about it. It's all over the place. You can't put a finger on it. You can't label it.
Yeah.
Здравствуйте. Девушка, я хочу фото зон, пожалуйста. Спасибо. Looks like we got a beach lounge scene. I'm sure this is a raging nightlife here, huh?
Yeah. It is true.
Enough.
Yeah.
Interesting. Did you know this existed?
There are several places like this.
Guys, I haven't gone into the real bad neighborhoods. Again, there are no real super bad, dangerous neighborhoods during the day. I did a video on these. Haven't gone to the outskirts where they're the decrepit apartment blocks, but I'm trying to, and I think I'm conveying a lot of this, the contrast here.
Nice. So, how do you feel?
I love this stuff. What are you getting my nose here?
He knows his craft, like he's a very experienced guy.
See, the stuff with experiences like this is you can't recreate, you know? They organically start and then become established. And if you ever tried to make this, you know, by design, it just wouldn't work.
Yeah.
That's what the city has.
These old guys getting into it.
People found this place. These are like real holes from the gun, from the
bullet holes.
Bullet holes, yes.
From 1917.
I guess 1917. I might be wrong about the year, but yes, these are real.
All right, guys, you've done quite a job revamping it, renovating it, and then this place over here, Kyiv Food Market. We're just gonna step in there for a second. I'll show you what that's all about. It's quite cool. This, I gotta say, is impressive. This whole scene.
Yeah.
Like, it goes on for a ways too, right? All the way down there.
Yeah. It's pretty beautiful and atmospheric, but in these small aisles.
Right.
Small, not everywhere, but when, like, you might...
You have zones like this.
Yes.
Well, let's go in the Kyiv Food Mart. This place is pumping.
great selection here. All different restaurants from, I think these are all restaurants in the city, right? Most of these places? I know Dogs and Tails is. So here we have restaurants in the city, but they have small restaurants here. There's gotta be at least 20 or so. Very cool atmosphere. This opened up in like the last year. Alright guys, hope you felt it today. The contrast of Kyiv. Just so you know, that's a very small scratch of the surface of this city. There are a lot of stories, a lot of narratives happening. And, well, that was just a bit. So, hope you felt that. Until the next one.
These old guys getting into it.